Water is used in virtually every aspect of human life, and our rate of consumption is evidently unsustainable. Only 2.5% of the world's volume of water is non-saline. Of that 2.5%, less than 1% is actually accessible for human consumption. This scarcity issue is fully realized in South Africa, where availability and access to water is a serious problem. This video discusses how water distribution in South Africa is failing its marginalized citizens and is a critique of the government's water policies. Although the South African Constitution guarantees a right to water, citizens of South Africa do not receive an adequate amount of safe water. The distribution of water in South Africa is inherently linked to the country's history of apartheid. Under apartheid, the black majority saw their environmental space limited by systems of institutionalized racism. Water distribution in South Africa has been bound by apartheid's system of racial planning and urban development. The black majority was excluded from water supply networks, while the white minority had access to an unlimited water supply. Even though it was abolished in 1994, the system of apartheid still influences water distribution in South Africa today. The political instability and the legacy of division in the country still leaves much of the poor black majority without water. A 2004 study showed that despite sweeping environmental and water reforms by Nelson Mandela and the ANC, 10 million people were affected by water cuts. The post-apartheid constitution of 1996 gave each municipality the right to govern the local affairs of its community, attempting to redistribute autonomy to local governments. However, at the same time as giving responsibility over municipal services such as water, the national government withdrew financial support for local governments. As a result, poor communities experience water cutoffs or lack water infrastructure because the local governments cannot afford to supply water without national government funds. Another one of the reforms to apartheid political structures was to rezone provinces. In the municipality of Hermanus, the town lines were redrawn and the government incorporated 8 additional communities into one province. The financial stress put on the local government of Hermanus was compounded by the political inexperience of the leaders in managing a larger municipality and resulted in massive distributional failures. Due to the absence of the national government in municipal affairs in post-apartheid South Africa, the country lacks a national regulator that ensures municipal compliance to national legislation, policy, and standards. Jackie Dugard, a researcher at the Socioeconomic Rights Institute of South Africa, states that in the absence of a national regulator, water delivery is largely operated as a commercial service. Under commercialization, multinational corporations treat water as a source of revenue and see privatizing South Africa's system as a profitable venture. Corporations such as Johannesburg Water Ltd. have implemented the free basic water allocation, a seemingly progressive policy, but in reality is exploitative. The free basic water policy is a free allocation of 6,000 liters of water to each property owner per month. According to the World Health Organization, each individual requires at least 50 liters of water per day. Many South African citizens have half of this bare minimum. With this free basic water allocation, each person in a typically large South African household has enough water to flush a toilet only 2 times per day, leaving no additional water to drink, wash themselves, or clean their clothes. Once the allocation is exhausted, usually 12 days into the month, the household's water meter shuts off and residents must purchase further credit for access to water. This policy systematically excludes poor communities from equitable access to water because there is a steep tariff curve for purchasing further water credits after the free basic water allocation is exhausted. The free basic water allocation would be sufficient for 4 people, but most South African households have many more. For instance, Vasumuzi Paki, a resident of the town of Soweto, shares the free basic water allocation with 9 people in his household. After only 12 days, the resident's water allocation ran out, and he was unable to purchase more water credits. Tragedy struck when a fire broke out in one of the backyard shacks of Paki's property. Paki and his neighbors were unable to put out the fire because all of the prepaid water was exhausted. The shack burned down, and 2 of his tenants' young children died in the fire. Packy's experience emphasizes the failures of the prepayment water system that are imposed on the poor. The more typical tragedy is that poor households still must rely on unsanitary water for most of the month. Questions of environmental injustice arise, considering that households in white areas and major cities enjoy much more access to water. In these areas, additional credits cost less, and there are less frequent water tap disconnections. Because these poverty-stricken communities have less political representation, the black majority is likely to experience more environmental injustice from corporations. As you can see, politically based institutionalized racism has maintained influence long after the abolition of apartheid. The commoditization of water in this unstable political system has led to the inequitable distribution of water throughout South Africa. In order to solve this environmental justice crisis, we need to go back to the root of the problem. The national government needs to take responsibility for equitable distribution and access to water. For instance, there needs to be a consistent regulator who can ensure that water tariffs under the free basic water system are set at a fair level. Affordability is a key issue that needs to be addressed. Also, the national government must provide financial support for local municipalities. This could entail the provision of cross subsidies to the public sector, which would lower the price of water and facilitate access to the service. Under economic philosophies and a neoliberal mindset, corporations treat water delivery as a business like any other. When doing so, they ignore the necessity to sustain each South African citizen's social and environmental rights. Water must not be treated as an economic good, but rather be recognized as a social good. Once this standard is met, South Africa will right its historical wrongs, and the country will begin to uphold the principles of environmental justice.